Okay, hey guys. Oh, fuck. We're getting ready to go and work out and also get some like BB Jen behind the scenes stuff. Mm-hmm. She's trying our new pre, so my new sponsor, Nutrix, the blueberry lemonade, Hema Rage.
It's pretty good.
It's not too sweet, but again, like I don't really like too strong of a flavor, the artificial flavor. I don't like.
I feel like we're matching.
I know. Almost. But anyways, so yeah, we're going into Boston to Gym Hub and yeah, we'll catch you there. So we're a little bit unsure. Oh my god, my hair. We're a little bit unsure about the parking because it says handicap until 6 p.m. So we think we're okay. So hopefully we're not gonna get a ticket. It's so bad. Like, I know, we never know how the city works. We're gonna start with some. We're gonna start with some hamstring curls to warm up. I like really warming up my knees and my joints pretty good before doing any leg work. Even though today I'm just doing some accessory glute work, I still like getting warmed up and doing that. Like extensions and leg curls are always my favorite way to warm up.
When did you do that?
For the last month. I have like 30 hours on this.
Clean.
Some hip thrust right now, nice and slow, really focusing on engaging the glutes from the beginning to the way up, pausing at the top, just like really feeling the engagement here, not trying to force any high reps personally on my first day of period, so kind of taking it easy today, but
TMI.
To love those of you. Could you speak up and stop my thumbing? I don't think you can. Machine right here, the shoulder machine.
The shoulder machine is life.
The shoulder machine is life. This one's so good. I've tried many similar ones and it just feels awful. This one's so good. Like, I want to take it home. I feel it like so much just in my shoulders, no traps at all. And you can adjust the height to it on the bottom because most of the time I'm too short for those machines, so I can never do them. So this one's really good. So yeah, this gym is really great if you guys are ever in Boston because you can come like late at night too, and it's always open and it's private, it's quiet, and the equipment is really good. And yeah, parking is a little tricky because it's city parking, but at night usually you always find parking, so it's always good. So definitely recommend go to Gym Hub Boston if you're ever here. It's literally probably the best gym in Boston, even though it's small, it is the best. And if you and the people who own it and all that stuff, they're super sweet. So yeah, definitely recommend.
So here's the city.
City of Boston. Nothing, not anything special. But yeah. Our car, by the way. Our car is there. So we didn't lose the car. We didn't get a ticket. So we're fine.
Hey, Rachel?
Yeah.
This is the post-workout meal. And it looks kind of gross because I put too much water in the cream of rice. But I swear to God, it tastes really good. It looks gross, but it's good. Don't just until you try it. And yeah, it's perfect post-workout. It's nice and quick.
Oh, my car.
Yo, literally some parking ticket truck just coming. Like parked behind us. Oh my god.
He's coming.
He's following us.
He's following us.
Like we literally got in the car and this parking guy was behind us, so we left. And then we just stopped to fix something. And he's like literally following us.
He's behind me still.
He's still behind us.
Oh, you wanna play?
I got you.
I think maybe because we have our lights on, it's weird.
I'm good. Right. We're good.
Jesus Christ. That was weird.
Out of breath carrying those boxes, but I can finally share the news with you guys.
I so got the box of goodies. So big news is, you guys, I'm finally an official Nutrix research athlete, sponsor athlete, guys. Like not like just like an affiliate thingy, like an actual sponsorship, which like if you know anything about me, right, like when I first started, you know, after my eating disorder and watching bodybuilding videos and going to the gym and literally not knowing what I'm doing, it was like the ultimate dream for me to be an athlete, to be a bodybuilder. That's all I wanted to do. And a lot of people were telling me, you know, that's unrealistic, that's dumb, you're a girl, you're not really supposed to, you're not gonna make a career out of this, things like that. And not that I would say that I have everything figured out right now, I'm still in the process, but I knew in my heart that I had doubts that, okay, maybe it isn't realistic, but it wasn't enough for me to give up on it. I'm like, okay, there may be a possibility that I won't turn out and I won't be like, you know, the biggest bodybuilding athlete of the world, but I'm gonna still work on it and see where it takes me. Oh my God, I even remember my first prep, you guys all know, I was like working 3 jobs plus my online coaching, plus then having to be in the gym 5-6 hours a day. Don't ask me how I did that. Like, honestly, I didn't really sleep much that prep, which probably wasn't great for prep and fat loss in general, made it a lot harder. But yeah, and I remember putting every penny towards bodybuilding. I went into debt sometimes for it. And I was trying to build all these things all together. And plus I was a kid, plus I was recovering from anorexia, plus like all these stuff that were going on. But I wanted to make a point. I truly believe that you can do anything you truly put your heart to do, as long as you pursue it. And pursue it with a clear vision and an open heart. I've said this many times to you guys, if you follow my Instagram, follow your vision and the rest will follow. I live by that saying. I don't know if I've read it somewhere or I kind of put it together myself or heard it, whatever, but I say that a lot to myself. Follow your vision and the rest will follow. Building is something very true to my heart. It's changed my life. It's given me my life back. And it's art in a way, right? You're taking your body and putting it through a transformation and truly creating whatever you want to create out of it. And that's how I really view it as. You know, there's intention. There's intention in your training. There's intention in your intensity, which is something that came along to me as my training slowly started to mature. It didn't happen. I didn't really grasp that in the beginning. Maybe as a concept, but not an actual training. I'm starting to really tap into that actually now, in this off season especially, which, you know, is making me fall in love with training even more. Like, I'm like a nerd junkie fangirl for training and the gym. And it's just making me love it even more. You know, it's putting me, I'm pushing myself more in the gym. I'm putting myself in more uncomfortable situations, but I'm also training in the mind of being the best bodybuilder can be, not, you know, lift the most, get the reps done, complete the workout. I remember watching all these YouTube videos, and right now here I'm on YouTube, and I remember, oh, look, it'd be so cool to be like one of those athletes and have like a sponsor, like, you know, and it's like, it starts small. It's like, not like a life changing, but like, to me, like, that would have been better than, like, winning $1 million, you know? And I was looking at that, and I was like, oh, okay. All right, here I am. Back then, I was like, okay, I want to go to the Olympia. Like, I'm going to have to win all these bodybuilding shows and become a pro and go to the Olympia, and then maybe one day I'm going to get a sponsorship. And I'm in a very lucky situation that, you know, I'm still an amateur in the sport, and you know, it's been a discussion for many months. I've used these products. I've tried them out for many, many months. I've actually really, really liked them. Because first of all, I didn't want to be with a company that I didn't like, nor that I didn't believe that the products were good, or they weren't at the right doses, or that I wouldn't use. I wanted to be able to use them. So first of all, I was trying them out, and they've sent me plenty. Second of all, the company has been great because the people there that I've talked to have been super nice. Like, they felt like family to me. And people and how you communicate, and like, it felt very real and natural versus just speaking to somebody from like a corporate office, like in email, or just like, oh, I'm trying to get you on. Like, it felt very personal, and I really value that. Also, another reason why I chose to go with them was because they have a reach internationally. So they're not just here. There's a great in you know, South America, I believe in Europe and in the Middle East. So that meant a lot to me, just because I'm from Greece, first of all, and I wanted for people back home, you know, maybe if they could reach out to do, but also because so happened that a lot of my following is in like Latin America and Brazil. So I also wanted you guys to be able to access it. I wanted part of my following. I have a lot of following in the States, but I also have an international following, as I am also international myself. So I wanted that for you guys, and it appealed to me. And the most, well, important reason too that I really wanted to join them was because they're gonna give me opportunities that I might be able to go to events, travel, and meet you guys. I really, like, I remember watching, like, the Gymshark and, like, old Alphalete videos where people would do the tours and, like, people would meet everybody. And I thought that was, like, so cool. Like, when, like,
going to the LA Fit, like all the Fit Expos was big, and Body Power, all that, right? I think it, still people do that, but I don't think it's how, like, it was like the fitness world was like based around those events, you know? I don't think it's so much right now as it was like maybe a couple, like five, six years ago, but I remember used to watch the video. I'm like, oh my god, I'm getting goosebumps right now. Like, I don't know. It would be so cool to meet you guys at some point in this year and to travel and see you guys and be able to do this opportunity. And mind you, this has nothing to do with the bodybuilding itself. That alone, it's gonna help me a lot. You know, being able to support me. You know, you guys, they gave me a code. So if you use code DAPH, DAPH, if you use the code DAPH, you get 30% off your order. So that's a huge discount. It's pretty unheard of. Usually like discounts are like 10%. So like you guys get 30% off your order. So it's so nice to be able to give you guys that back. But also if you use your code, it does support me. And you know, I'm juggling a lot of things and trying to make this happen and trying to go pro as a bodybuilder is a lot of work, but you guys are helping my dreams come true. So I'm glad that I can give something back to you guys, support your fitness journeys, and you guys, if you use my code, please screenshot, send me a DM, and I would love to thank you personally. It'll literally make my day. I can't believe that this happened to me during my off season as an amateur, building my way to become a pro. I chose a very longer route, kind of underground, away from fame, away from the stage route to go. With bodybuilding, I've been told many times, you could have been in bikini, you could already be competing, you could have done good. And it may be true. I mean, there's a lot of bikini girls. I'm not saying I would go and, like, you know, beat everybody. I'm not saying that. I would still need to build muscle, but it would be way easier and I would be more in the spotlight, so to speak. You know, I chose to take a longer time away from the stage and away from the people as an amateur, not really being well known, like, I guess, as a bodybuilding athlete in that realm, and take a step back to really build the physique that I want, because I wanted to move up in categories. Right now, I'm aiming for wellness. And, you know, a lot of people have told me, you know, different opinions. But as I said, that's just kind of where my heart is. And I'm willing to take the time. I'm trying to do something that also speaks to me more. I really like to train hard. I guess I don't get to train upper body as much as I would like to. But, you know, in all realms of everything, I do love wellness. I do love the category. I used to watch it, you know, before it really became the States, because it was in Europe and it was in Brazil. You guys enjoyed this video. If you're going to get anything, as I said, use code DAPH, get a discount and screenshot so I can thank you. And just remember that truly everything you want out of this life will work to your advantage if you pursue with an open heart. I posted that quote recently, but it's true. Follow your vision and the rest will follow. Love you guys. And as always, win the day and keep lifting. Mwah.